I really love this question. That's. I really love this question. Let's have a look. I really love this question. Let's have a look. We have x plus y is equal to 8, and we are going to find the maximum of x to the y's power. Well, let's make some observations first. If there's no conditions on the x and y, we can do this. Let's say x is equal to negative 2. In that case, y was just equal to 10. And then we are just talking about negative 2 to the 10th power. Work that out, we get 1024. Can we make it bigger? Yes. X equals negative 4, y equals 12, and negative 4 raised to the 12th power, I don't know what it is, but it's for sure bigger than that. So as you can see, if there's no conditions on x and y, this question is not that fun, right? Because you can just do things like that. So let's impose a condition. We want these two numbers both to be non-negative. Well, let's see. What if x and y are just whole numbers? If we have x is equal to 5, that means y will just be equal to 3, then we are looking at 5 to the third power, which is 125, okay? And if x is equal to 4, that means y is equal to 4 as well, then we are looking at 4 to the fourth power, which is 256. Good. And if x is equal to 3, y will be 5, then 3 to the 5th power, work that out, we get 243. And of course, you can also try 2 and 6, but you can see that right here. I think this is the biggest. In fact, if you have x and y being whole numbers, this is indeed the biggest. However, the condition right here is that there's no conditions on x and y have to be whole numbers. What if we try some decimal numbers, such as put x to be 3.5. In that case, y will be 4.5, and then if we do 3.5 to the 4.5th power, this right here is approximately 280.7, which is bigger than that. Okay, that's the answer done. No, what if x is the 3.51 or something? Right? Of course, we're not going to just keep guessing a check, and definitely there's a way to do it, and we can just use the calculus one method. This is just an optimization question, but it's not so easy because you know what I'm wearing this shirt for, right? So let's see how we can do this. Firstly, x plus y is equal to 8, and we want to maximize this. Let's call this to be p, and then let's write this in terms of just x. So from here we know y is just 8 minus x. Put that here. So we are looking at p as a function of x is just x to the 8 minus x. By the way, p for power. And let's just do the typical calculus one thing. Finding the derivative of this, set equal to 0, find the critical numbers, and make sure that it does give us a maximum. Well, to take the derivative of this, let's rewrite the base x as base e. And to do so, we just purposely write this as e to the ln x power. E and ln cancel, we get the x back. Then raise that to the 8 minus x power. Multiply the powers, I'll just put it here, 8 minus x. Look at this and take the derivative. P prime of x is equal to the derivative e to the whatever, just repeat that first, e to the 8 minus x times ln x, and then use the chain rule. Multiply by the derivative right here. Keep the first part, which is 8 minus x times the derivative of the second, because this is the product rule. I forgot to mention earlier. And then keep the second function times the derivative of the first, which is negative 1. All right, then let's just kind of put things in a nice way. This right here is just that, which is the same as that. We have x to the 8 minus x power. And then this right here, I'll just write it as 8 minus x over x minus ln x. All right, that's the first derivative. And to get the critical numbers, of course, set equal to 0. We have a product of two things equal to 0, meaning this right here should give us 0. Or the other one, 8 minus x over x minus ln x should also give us 0. For the first one, by observation, x is equal to 0. However, when x is equal to 0, if you put that back for the y, y is equal to 8. Then in that case, we will see that we get 0 to the 8, which is just 0. This is going to be a minimum. That's not what we want. Right? And of course, you can also do the first derivative test, but that's just the minimum. Now, this is our hope. And this is why this question is so much more difficult than the usual calculus 1 optimization questions. Because in order to solve for x right here, we will have to use the Lambert W function. Well, check this out first. Whenever we have x to whatever power, and natural log, yeah, you can give Lambert W function a try. Not guaranteed though, all right? So let me show you guys how we can work this out. Firstly, of course, I will remind you guys what this is about. The idea is that if today you have a fish, all right, times e to the fish power, and then you see that these two fishes are the same. Well, I don't know. If you take the Lambert W function, then you will actually get the fish back. So our goal is to first write this into this kind of form. And by doing so, we will have to first put all the x's on one side, right? Let's try that first. So right here, I'm going to first move this to the other side, and let me also multiply x on both sides. So we are getting 8 minus x equals x times ln x. But right here, we still have the minus x, right? Let's put that to the other side, and then both terms will have the x. Let's factor that out. So we are looking at 8 equals x times ln x plus 1. Now, check this out. For this x right here, this is the part that we do the usual trick. Because we really want to introduce the e, so we do the following. Write this as e to the ln x power, and then this right here stays in the front right here, ln x plus 1, and then we still have the 8 right here, isn't it? This and that are almost the same, but not quite exact. We really want to make sure that they are exactly the same. We have a plus 1, so how can we somehow introduce a plus 1 in the exponent? Just multiply e to the first power. If we multiply e to the first power on both sides, don't we just have to add the exponents? Yeah? And then you will see that this is just ln x plus 1, and that will match with that, and we will be able to use the Lambert W function. And that's so nice. We are looking at 8e equals, and we have just ln x plus 1 times e to the ln x plus 1. Now, ladies and gentlemen, use the Lambert W function. Go ahead and take the W here, take the W here, hold the W, you know? That's the idea. Let's write down this right here first. Ln x plus 1, just one of them. Yeah, just one of them, just like that. And then on the right-hand side, let's put that down. W of 8e. To solve x, move the 1 to the other side and exponentiate both sides. So x equals e raised to this power. And then the minus 1 was also in the exponent. And that's the x value. And if you enter this on Wolfram alpha, you will get approximately 3.5354. So the guess that we had earlier, 3.5, was pretty close. And now, of course, let's also figure out the y, but if you want to end up with the same looking answer like on Wolfram alpha, then do the following. Check this out. Firstly, we can write e to this power minus 1 as this. X is just equal to e to this power, and then over e to the first. Yeah, so that's good. And in fact, this part we can actually simplify. Well, to do so, remember the Lambert W function is the inverse of x times e to the x. So if you have the following, W of, let's say the fish right here, and then times e raised to the W of the fish. You are going to get a fish back, right? You are going to get a fish back. And if you want to have e to the w, all you have to do is divide this on both sides. So if you do that, you will see that, just go ahead and bring that right here, right? So in fact, this right here, we can write it down like this. The inside is the fish. We have 8e, so that goes to the top right here, and then over w of the fish, which is ae, like that. Yeah, but don't forget we still have an over e on the bottom, like this. And of course, this e and that e cancel out very nicely, so we can see that x is equal to 8 over w of ae. And of course, y is equal to 8 minus x. Let's go ahead and write that down right here. So we have 8 minus 8 over w of 8e. And finally, we just have to put them together to get the answer. Well, I will write that down right here for you guys. That will give us the maximum. X to the y's power. Well, if you want to end up with the same answer like on Wolf and Alpha, I don't know why they gave us the answer for the x right here for the critical number, but if you want to end up with the final result, use this form, it's easier. So for the x, is that e to the w of 8e minus 1, and then we will have to raise that to the y's power, and right here, let's do some algebra. Let's first factor out the 8, and then combine the fractions. And you will see that they will just have the same denominator, which is w of 8e. Multiply the top and bottom by w of 8e. So here we have another w of 8e. And then minus 1, because I put that in the front already. And by doing so, you will see that after we multiply the exponents, we can just multiply this and put that together and raise that to the second power. So the final answer will be, we have e for the base, and then w of 8e, and then on the top right here is 8 in the front, and w of 8e minus 1 raised to the second power, just like that. And if you want to know the approximation, this right here is approximately 280.9. Very cool, huh?